what you think about when you're born into a fire. Let 'em burn, let 'em burn it out. Sell 'em to the richest buyer. They wanna let the world decay. They tell us lies and fade away. Never let the truth fade away. This is bigger than ourselves. We won't let the world burn away.
Welcome, friends, to UC Baseball Stadium. In today's matchup, the third and final of the season between Cincinnati Bearcats and the Xavier Musketeers. It is a very, very windy day, 76 degrees at time of first pitch. And joined alongside Kerry Campbell, I'm Ethan Herzog. And now I'm completely blowing this one. This is real great. As Kira Campbell makes her broadcast debut, I've been doing this for 4 years, and I'm not prepared to speak at all. But these two teams both going through tough schedules. Cincinnati currently sitting at a 21-16 record. Xavier sitting at a 17-18 record coming out of the Big East. And Xavier, up to this point, has had a lot of tough competition coming forward into today's matchup.
Yeah, I think Xavier's had a tougher schedule than Cincinnati has. They've played LSU at LSU, Tennessee at Tennessee, and they still are playing Kentucky later on in the year, as well as Oklahoma before they come here to face the Bearcats.
Like you had just mentioned, Cincinnati facing off against TCU LSU. Also took down Louisville 9-1, took one game from LSU in that three-game series, 2-1, but got swept by Clemson, 3-14, 3-8-7, 2-11. And in their upcoming schedule, they will be playing Oklahoma. That is the fourth and final time that they will be playing a Big 12 team this season, as that is on May 14th. And on the other side for Cincinnati, they'll play UConn, which will be the fourth and final time that Cincinnati plays a Big East team this season. That game also on May 14th, that at 11 a.m. It is Education Day here at UC Baseball Stadium. And backtracking here to our pitching matchup that we'll highlight here in the pregame, it's the young gun versus the experienced in Carson Marsh and Connor Bailey. Carson Marsh, a Cincinnati native out of Muller High School, has made countless starts this season, and Connor Bailey, same thing on the other side for Xavier, made 15 appearances in 2023 and is a three-time offender as a member of the Big East All-Academic team. And before we get to that, we will send it to a quick break and talk about those pitchers on the other side of this timeout. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcats Sports Radio. Welcome back inside UC Baseball Stadium. Cincinnati Bearcats and Xavier Musketeers just about underway. Cincinnati in their second straight midweek game, which has not happened in a very long time for the Bearcats, took down the Eastern Kentucky Colonels by a 12-2 run rule win yesterday. All that story started by Josh Cross with a three-run bomb that about 441 feet off the bat of the catcher of today's game, Josh Cross. But before we get to the starting lines for each team, we'll revisit the starting pitchers for both sides, starting with Cincinnati. is looking at Carson Marsh's line coming into this season. 29 innings pitched. Coming into today's contest, 30 hits, 18 runs, 18 of which are earned with 8 walks and 34 Ks. And on the other side, Connor Bailey, 24.1 innings pitched, 22 hits, 18 runs, 15 of which are earned with 17 walks and 20 punchouts on the season so far. And this is also a revisit for these two pitchers who pitched in the Joe Nuxhall Classic just a little bit ago. Carson Marsh didn't start the game. Brendan Garula did start that match. But Carson Marsh would come in relief and pitch a strong outing against Xavier and Connor Bailey and would win that one 5-2.
Yeah, Connor Marsh got the win there. Good for him. Connor Bailey was credited with the loss in that one, but it's basically a rematch of the game just about a week ago, so it'll be interesting to see how these pitchers face off again.
This is the third and final time this season these two teams will face off. Cincinnati and Xavier splitting the series this season 1-1. Xavier took it in a comeback win at Xavier at Hayden Field just this past February. And Cincinnati just took the most recent contest between these two teams up at Prasco Park, the host site of the Big East Tournament. Xavier, a co-host of the Big East Tournament coming up this postseason. Cincinnati will make their Big 12 tournament debut this season.
Hopefully.
They'll make the tournament. Don't be so negative here. The Big 12 tournament runs from May 21st to May 25th.
Yeah, and then take the top 10 teams out of the Big 12 there. So I think UC will make it, but it'll be interesting to see. It's interesting right now. TCU's kind of hovering around there, and I think it'll be hard to play come the tournament.
21-16 is the Bearcats' record. Did sweep the preseason favorite in TCU just a few weeks ago. And a very strong outing for Cincinnati. That was their second of now 3 run rule wins for Cincinnati when they took down TCU earlier this season. But now we'll take a look at the starting lines for both teams, starting with the visiting Xavier Musketeers. In the one spot, the third baseman, number 3, Luke Hammond. Batting second, the center fielder, number 9, Aiden Anderson. Batting third, the left fielder, number 24, Hayden Christensen. In the 4 spot, the second baseman, number 32, Jared Cushing. In the 5 spot at first base is number 25, Matt McCormick. Batting 6, the catcher, number 15, Matthew Dupre. In the 7th spot, the designated hitter, number 1, Connor Mish. In the 8th spot, the right fielder, number 31, Carter Hendrickson. And batting 9th, the shortstop, number 40, Jake Lambden. And on the mound for Xavier, Connor Bailey. Now on the other side for Cincinnati, batting 1st, 3rd baseman, number 2, Carrington Cross. In the 2 spot, the center fielder, number 22, Josh Hegeman. In the 3 spot, the catcher, number 41, Josh Cross. In the 4 spot, the left fielder, number 5, Hunter Jesse. In the 5 spot, the first baseman, number 44, Tommy O'Connor. Batting 6th, the shortstop, number 8, Loudon Brooks. In the 7th spot, the second baseman, number 6, Max Palmieri. In the 8th spot, the designated hitter, number 31, Luf Sefcik. And in the 9th spot, the right fielder, number 14, Landon Vitterick. And on the mound for Cincinnati, warming up currently, Carson Marsh. Out for Cincinnati. Another start on the season. Be his 17th appearance for the Bearcats. Allowed 6 home runs on the year, 34 punch-outs, 8 walks. All runs have been earned for him, meaning 18 runs have been earned for Carson Marsh. And it is a windy day here in Cincinnati. Winds blowing southwest at 18 miles an hour at time of first pitch. And it's just that cold front that's decided to make its way in to the Ohio Valley. Cloudy day, 76 degrees. So we're just about underway here in Cincinnati. Kira Campbell, Ethan Herzog with you. You're on the student voice of the Cats, Bearcats Sports Radio. Don't you laugh at me. We need branding. No one else is going to do it. Heading up to the plate, number 3, Luke Hammond. for Xavier. Hammond, a Cincinnati native, went to Indian Hill High School, 6'4" junior. Bats with his right. Carson Marsh throwing with his right. We're just about underway here. Marsh deals to the plate. Swing and a high drive up into right field. Going back to track it down is Vitterick. He makes the catch. A couple steps from the warning track, and that's the first out of the top half of the first inning. Now coming up, Aiden Anderson. Aiden Anderson, a hot hand for the Xavier Musketeers. He leads the team in home runs with 10, is second in the Big East. Marsh looks at a plate, the wind, the deal. Down and away, 4-1, 1-0. The count now with one out. Nobody on for Xavier. After Hammond flies out to right. Marsh sets the pitch. Down in the strike zone, strike one. 91 miles an hour.
Look at you with the track, man.
Hey, man, I got it from Chris Colm, the SID. I'm going to use it. The pitch. Down away, ball two. Sun starts to peek out here at UC Baseball Stadium that desperately needs a new name.
The wind's kind of calmed down, too. For now.
Marsh the pitch, swing and a miss. Strike two. Evens the count at two with one out. Nobody on for the Musketeers. Nice pitch there, got Anderson to bite. The wind, the deal, swung on and hit. Foul, is not foul up the first baseline, and Carson Marshall taking himself for the second out. He's able to track it down, ball trickled down the first baseline, stayed fair, and Carson Marsh able to pick it up and take it himself off his own glove. Brings up the second out, and Hayden Christensen, no, not famed actor, but Xavier baseball player up to the plate. .309 batting average on the season. .326 with two outs as that pitch down to the dirt for ball one. 42-136 on the season. 16 runs, 29 RBIs. Forward to left fielder. Marsh, the pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one. As I will say, I do not know what goes through the minds of the people running the soundboard here at UC Baseball Stadium.
Oh, that's fantastic.
The 1-1 pitch. Swing on and driven into center field, tracking it all the way. All the way over is Hegeman. And that'll retire the side for the Xavier half of the first inning when we come back. Bottom of the first in Cincinnati's first time up to the plate. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcats Sports Radio. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. Carson Marsh able to get out of the top half of the first inning unscathed. 1-2-3 inning, a fly out. put out and another fly out. To head into the bottom half of the first inning. Carrington Cross on deck for Cincinnati. It's Connor Bailey. Works the mound for his warm-up, favoring the third base side of the rubber. He's 2-for-1 on the year, 24 innings pitched, 22 hits allowed, 18 runs, 15 of which are earned, 20 punch-outs and 17 walks on the year. He's only allowed 2 home runs on the season. Carrington Cross, .321 average, 42 runs off 44 hits, 33 RBIs, 32 walks, 5 home runs on the season as well for Carrington Cross. Carrington Cross also leads the team in walks, is tied for second in the Big 12, is 39th in the country in walks. A very patient batter.
As are all of Jordan Bishel's players.
That
he preaches plate patience, getting on base, working the count, so it makes sense.
That pitch in the zone, outside the zone for strike one, as called by home plate umpire. It's Connor Bailey meets Carrington Cross for the third time this season. The pitch in the zone for strike two. 0-2 the count, quickly down is Carrington Cross. Cincinnati last time out was able to score 5 runs in the bottom of the first inning. The pitch on the way, check swing, did not go, ball one. 1-2 the count now. Josh Cross is able to hit a 441-foot home run. That would put the Cats up 5-0. In that bottom of the first inning. Bailey the pitch. Swung on, driven into the gap between center and right field, and that'll be a base hit for Carrington Cross. Charging his way to second base, he'll be in there standing. Relay will not be in time. Lead off double for Carrington Cross. Anderson and Hendrickson racing towards the outfield wall to make the grab, couldn't get there in time. Fell just inside the gap.
Yeah, that gap in right field is going to be an issue all game with this win. And the wall's just going to carry out there.
Now Josh Hageman, the center fielder, up to bat. The .398 leads the team in batting average. Pitch on the way. High and outside for ball one. Hageman's batting average also second in the Big 12, 53rd in the country. So he looks to work against Connor Bailey. The pitch in the zone for strike one. Bailey and the Musketeers wearing their all grays, blue caps with blue numbers. Cincinnati, all blacks, white numbers, and black caps. As you can hear the wind picking up just slightly, Bailey looks to second. Looks for the pitch, fouled off down the third baseline. Carrington Cross with a decent sized lead over at second base. Connor Bailey keeping an eye on things. Cross on about 3-4 steps off the bag. Bailey looks back to second to Cross. Waits, now winds, deals. Swung on and popped high down the third baseline. Going to track it down is Hammond. Hammond into the sun is able to make the catch. Keeps Carrington Cross at second. That'll be a fly out for Josh Hageman. That's a tough spot over on that third base wall. A couple of plays yesterday were made or almost made. Third baseman yesterday for Cincinnati slamming into that brick wall, trying to make a grab. Now the man that did it all yesterday, Josh Cross, up to the plate. Hit home run number 13 on the season yesterday. Cross on second. Carrington Cross on second. Josh Cross at the plate. Bailey back pick to second, not in time. Hesitated on on that back pick. Reset the pitch clock. So now I believe it's shorter.
I believe that's correct. I think they shortened it in college.
I believe it's shorter by 10 seconds. Pitch on the way, swung on and missed. Strike one for Josh Cross. And
college always gets to try out the new rules before the majors do, just like the minor leagues.
I was just about to say, college and the minor leagues always get the new rules
but
before
the majors. College still
the
has
majors.
The smaller bags.
They do.
Mm-hmm.
No shift, though, is the pitch on the way. Swung on, driven in the center field. Anderson has a bead on it, makes his way up, and makes that catch for the second out of the inning. Josh Cross flies out and brings up Hunter Jesse up to the plate for Cincinnati. Carrington Cross still at second base. Hunter Jesse, .256 average on the year, 23 RBIs, one home run. Graduate student.
Transfer from Indiana.
Bearcats will play Indiana coming up next month. Pitch on the way in the zone for strike one. Trying our best to make it out to Bloomington, Indiana for that matchup. Cincinnati's played Indiana the past couple of years. Bailey looks the second, the pitch. Swung on, driven down the third baseline, but foul. Trying to make his way over is Christensen, but it sails into the Cincinnati dugout, the 0-2. 0-2 the count, two outs for Cincinnati. Hunter Jesse trying to bring in the lone runner in Carrington Cross at second base. Killing us here is that pitch high and away for ball one. If Hunter Jesse can work his way back up the count, down 1-2. Bailey's walked 9 times on the air, struck out 20. Bailey looks to second, looks for the pitch. Outside, ball two. Harrington Cross takes his steps out. Cross, 12 stolen bases on the year, has been caught once. One of 5 Bearcats in the top 15 in stolen bases in the Big 12. Is that pitch fouled off? 2-2 still the count. Cross on second. Hunter Jesse at the plate for Cincinnati. Connor Bailey, the pitcher for the Musketeers, looks to second, winds and deals. Swung on, driven into right field, and that ball is gone. Off the roof of Fifth Third Arena, a two-run bomb, 377 feet for Hunter Jesse. Home run number 2 on the year. Kiss that ball goodbye. Just don't shatter the window of Fifth Third Arena.
It's supposed to be unbreakable glass, so.
Well, we'll see. 100 mile an hour hit off the bat of Hunter Jesse. Puts the Bearcats up 2-0 and brings Tommy O'Connor to the plate. He has 10 home runs on the year himself.
Including one yesterday.
A 2 home run game for the Bearcats yesterday. Josh Cross and Tommy O'Connor. Is that one tapped down to the first base side? McCormick snags it, taps the bag, and that retires the side, but not before Cincinnati cracks this one open. 2-0 is the score as we head to the top of the second inning. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcats Sports Radio.
Sitting on the earth.
Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. The Bearcats leading 2-0 as we head to the top half of the second inning between the Bearcats and the Musketeers. Carson Marsh back to the mound for another inning of work. The wind just will not die down. Pitch on the way in the zone, strike one. As I'm sure you can hear the brutalness of this wind. Pitch on the way, swung on and missed, strike two. Jared Cushing up to bat for Xavier. .271 batting average, 36 hits, 25 runs, 29 RBIs. Pitch on the way, swung on and driven fair down the third baseline, and he'll be safe at first and go for two. And he'll slide in safely after a relay from Hunter Jesse is not in time. So a leadoff double for the Musketeers puts Cushing on, brings Matt McCormick up to the plate. Matt McCormick, who has been a problem for Cincinnati throughout the years, .288 batting average on the season, 11 home runs as well, 38 hits, 33 RBIs, three doubles. As he steps up to work against Carson Marsh. Marsh looks back to second, now to home, the pitch. Outside, ball one. One of the count against Matt McCormick. Senior first baseman, the pitch on the way. Outside, ball two. One just proving to be a factor here. Carson Marsh now down the count, 2-0. Pitch on the way, swung on, driven down the first base line. Picked up by the second baseman, over to O'Connor at first. Be out at first, but not before advancing the runner in Cushing to third base. Now he stands 90 feet away. And up to bat now, number 15, Matt Dupre for Xavier. 1 out, one man on third. It's Cushing. The pitch swung on and missed. Strike one called. Dupre, .274 batting average on the year. 37 of 135, 25 runs, 10 RBIs. Marsh readies, winds the deals. Swung on and hit, blooped into the gap between center and left field, brings in Cushing, scores the first run for Xavier. The Musketeers now trail by 1-2-1 here top of the second inning. Connor Mish now the designated hitter, .263 batting average off his 20 hits, 9 RBIs on the year. Looks to bring in Dupre, just had a bloop single. Marsh. The pitch, swung on, check swing, he went. 0-1 the count, and it looked close. Mish down 0-1. One out, one man on. He stands at first base. Connor Marsh favoring the third base side of the rubber. The pitch on the way, in the zone, strike two. 0-2 now the count. Dupre is your runner on first base. Carson Marsh looks to retire the side here. Double play is possible. Pitch on the way, swung on, fouled off. Bouncing past Josh Cross. Carson Marsh looks over to first, a small lead for Dupre over at first base. Marsh, the pitch, swung on, popped up, and out of play. Bounce over into the ticket office.
Into the construction.
I had a dollar for every time there was a foul ball that bounced into the ongoing construction behind us, building the all-new practice facility. That athletic training facility, I guess I should say. It's
the football facility.
Yeah.
We don't think it's too fancy. We all know what it is.
0-2 the count. Swung on, popped, foul once again over into the construction. Another souvenir for one of the construction workers back behind us. I'm sure they probably have gone home for the day. 5:26 in the afternoon.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe came over and caught a couple innings of Bearcat baseball. Marsh, the 0-2 pitch. Down and away, 4-1. 84-mile-an-hour pitch. Slider down and away. One out, 1-2 the count. With Mish at the plate.
Ooh.
And he plunks him.
Bad.
That will advance Dupre to second, Mish to first. Cincinnati.
And this is Carson Marsh's problem, is he has good stuff, but he's a freshman and his control is not there yet. And you'll see a lot of walks, some hit batters. So it'll be interesting to see if he can get it back under control.
Cincinnati, 48, now 49 hit batters, leads the Big 12 in hit batters. This pitch on the way in the zone. Excuse me, too high, it would be 1. Mentioned in the opening of the show, that's your young gun, as that pitch is swung on and popped up into the air. Loudon Brooks has an eye on it, makes his way over, makes the catch, holds the runners at first and second, gets the second out. Like I was saying before, it's your young gun and your veteran going up against each other once again, and Carson Marsh and Connor Bailey for Cincinnati and Xavier, respectively. Carson Marsh doing a good job here as Lambden batting in the 9 spot for Xavier. That one swung on, driven to the center field. It will be a base hit, advance the runners. One runner will score. Relay to third base is in time. Oh. Catches the runner at third, out.
I think Xavier's going to challenge that one.
And there may be a challenge, but not.
Oh, no.
Not looking so, as that one will be the tying run. Ties things up at 2 as we head to the bottom half of the second inning. Cincinnati and Xavier tied at 2 apiece here on Bearcat Sports Radio.
It's not a bad thing.
We'll go back to UC Baseball Stadium, all tied up at two. Cincinnati with two hits, Xavier with three. So we have the Cincinnati half of the second inning. Loudon Brooks making his way to the plate for the first time today. .316 batting average on the season. 34 runs off 37 hits. Connor Bailey looks, winds, deals, swung on, hit over to the shortstop. He gathers, fires at the first base, and he'll have Loudon Brooks in time for the first out of the bottom half of the second inning. Contact being made between these both teams, just not enough to get more than one runner on at a time for Cincinnati. Xavier's able to get a handful on and bring a couple in. Ties things up at two. Max Palmieri now steps up to the dish. That pitch in the zone for strike one. Max Palmieri, .214 on the year so far. Has not seen much action as three hits on 14 at-bats. Winds and deals, outside ball one. Evens the count at one. Three walks, four strikeouts on the year for Mr. Palmieri. Connor Bailey looks to home, winds the pitch. Swung on and hit. Same spot as Loudon Brooks. Gathers, fires to first base, and it will be in time. Catching Max Palmieri. He'll head back to the dugout. And up comes Luke Sefcik for Cincinnati. Connor Bailey looking for a 1-2-3 inning. He's done so quite easily up to this point. Retired the first two he's seen, looking for his third. None by way of the K just yet. Bailey receives the sign, winds the pitch. In the zone, strike one, 93 mile an hour, right down Broadway. Luke Sefcik, 300 batting average on the year, 21 hits, 9 RBIs, 10 walks. Pitch on the way. Outside for ball one. Counts even at one. Pitch on the way. In the zone for strike two. Count now stands at 1-2, two outs for Cincinnati. Luke Sefcik at the plate, taps that one into the gap between first and second. It'll be a standing single for Luke Sefcik. It's the first man on for Cincinnati in the bottom half of the second. This was where the magic happened last time out. In that last inning. Landon Vitterick makes his way to the plate for the first time today, batting in the ninth spot. Hunter Jesse hit a two-run shot with two outs, bottom half of the first. Landon Vitterick steps up to the plate. He has four home runs on the year. Is that pitch inside the zone four, strike one. Oh, on the count now, two outs. Tied at two between the Musketeers and the Bearcats here on Bearcat Sports Radio. Landon Vitterick with his .232 batting average on the season. Pickoff attempt the first, not in time. Bailey tries to hit McCormick, catch Sefcik out to no avail. Bailey, pick again the first base, not in time. Nice showing of fans now as the game's now underway.
Decent amount of Xavier fans as well.
I mean, it's not hard to do when you're only 3.2 miles from each other.
Yeah, I just didn't know they existed, so.
0-1 still the count, two picks in a row. Now the pitch swung on and driven foul into the Xavier bullpen. Swinging for the fences is Landon Bitterick. Trying to put the Bearcats up by two once again. Count now stands 0-2, two outs. Bitterick awaits the pitch from Connor Bailey. Winds and deals outside, ball one. Way high. Higher 91 mile an hour pitch for Connor Bailey. Sussex stands at first. Bitterick at the plate. It's his first appearance of the day. Pitch on the way, swung on, driven foul. Back into the safety net. Behind home plate. Thank God for that safety net. I'll never forget the time that I almost got hit by a foul ball. I called a game at Louisville. Almost came straight into my window of my booth.
Please shout a booth.
Pickoff attempt not in time to first base. 1-2 the count, two outs for Landon Vitterick, trying to extend the inning. Pitch on the way, swing and a miss, strike three called, and that will be it for the bottom half of the second inning, still tied at two between the Bearcats and Musketeers. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcast Sports Radio. Bearcats have gone to the bullpen. Right out number 40, Drew Erdman, right-handed pitcher out of Hudson, Ohio. Attended Walsh Jesuit High School. Varsity letter winner in baseball and football. Back in high school. Seventh appearance on the year, 7.1 innings pitched. 12 hits, 12 runs, nine of which are earned as he comes out the pitch for Xavier for the first time in his career. It's an ERA of 11.05, pitch on the way, outside, ball one. Gun around the order for Xavier, now back up to Luke Hammond. He's 0-for-1 on the day. Flew out.
to right last time out.
Pitch on the way. Low and away for ball two. This wind is ruthless and unforgiving.
It'd be a nice day to have a box in the press box.
By the dollar for every time you said that, and it's only the top half of the third. 2-1 the count now. As Drew Erdman comes in for relief, Coach Jordan Bischel going to the pen early. That one fouled out of play. Liner over in the construction site. Hopefully a dump truck doesn't have its window shattered. I don't know why you're looking at me like that. Even the count of 2-2. Hold on.
No reason.
Okay. That one fouled into the safety net once again down the first base line. Count remains 2-2. Two runs apiece for both these teams. 3 hits apiece, no errors. They sit here top of the third inning. This crosstown rivalry matchup. Time is called. Adjustments had to be made for Josh Cross. C sits ready now. Erdman ready. Hammond ready. Erdman favoring that first base side. Pitch on the way. Ball three. Full count. First full count of the day for either pitcher. Hammond looking for his first hit. Pitch on the way. Swung on. Driven foul. Into the stands. There's a Dan Skillings sighting.
Sure is.
Dan Skillings in attendance. Dante Corleone also in attendance. I think he's also seen Dan Skillings. He's pointing over in that direction. Full count now. Erdman the pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike 3 called. First punch out of the day for either pitcher. Sends Hammond back to the dugout. Nice pitch there from Erdman. 93 miles an hour, top of the zone. He's able to find the first punch out of the day for either side. Cincinnati pitching. Last time out, 11 strikeouts against Eastern Kentucky. Pitch on the way in the zone, strike 1. As Anderson steps up to the plate. Grounded out. His first time up. He now sits down 0-1. Erdman deals. Swing and a drive. Oh. Missed by the third baseman. Fires from deep third. It's safe. Relay not in time. Carrington Cross tried to pick it up, but couldn't get a handle on it. Had to go to Lawton Brooks, and Brooks had a nice arm on it, and it made its way over to O'Connor, just not in time. So now Hayden Christensen steps up to the plate. 0-1 on the day as well. Erdman with one man on. That pitch outside for ball 1. Officially be called an error for Cincinnati. Anderson reaches that pitch in the dirt, ball 2. Christensen flew out his first time out. Christensen looks to bring home Anderson. That pitch way too close for comfort, ball 3. Real hitters count here for Christensen. Erdman looking to tighten things up here. 1 out, pitch on the way. Outside, ball 4. That'll be a walk for Christensen. Runners will advance. Christensen will stand on first. Anderson now on second. Now Jared Cushing steps up. He's 1-for-1 on the day. Winds and deals. That pitch in the zone, strike one. 0-1 now the count. He had a leadoff double in the Xavier half of the second inning. As Urban looks to second, now forward, the pitch swung on, driven in the center field. Has a beat on his Hegman. Hegman at the warning track makes the catch, fires it back, holds the runners at first and second, and brings in the second out of the top of the third. Great eyes from Josh Hegman. Able to get a beat on that one quickly, track that one down. Brings out Cushing, now McCormick up to the plate for Xavier. He grounded out the top of the second. Urban the second, looks the second now to home. Pitch outside for ball one. Runner in scoring position is Anderson. He stands at second base. Christensen with a couple steps off first base. No first baseman is there. Tommy O'Connor with a couple steps back. Off the bag is that pitch outside, ball two. No pickoff at first or second as the second baseman as well is off the bag. That pitch high, ball three. 3-0 count, two outs, two runners on for Xavier. McCormick, a dangerous hitter for the Musketeers. .286 is his batting average. The pitch on the way. Inside for ball four, and that'll be a four-pitch walk for Cincinnati. Bases loaded, two outs. Matt Dupre steps up to the plate. With the bases loaded. And a chance to take a four-run lead with the swing of a bat. Pitch in the dirt for ball one. Real pickle here for Drew Erdman. Striking out one batter. Allowed hits and walks to load the bases. That one in the zone, strike one. Count even at one, two outs. Dupre, who was 1-for-1, had a single in the top half of the second, an RBI. Pitch on the way. High, ball two. This is a midweek game, so you'll probably see a lot of pitching changes between both these sides. Didn't see much pitching changes last time out against Eastern Kentucky. Pitch on the way. Swung on and popped foul. Out of play.
The Bearcats had a pretty comfortable lead all of yesterday, so.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. So I'm sure Jordan Bischel said yesterday. Not so much today. 2-2 the count, two outs. Erdman winds and deals. Swung on and foul. Two's across the board. McCormick at first, Christensen at second, Anderson at third for the Musketeers. Dupre looks to bring in at least one. Take the first lead of the game for Xavier. Erdman favoring the first base side. Winds and deals, tip foul. Sailed into, almost into the Xavier dugout. So we're playing the Imperial March, but they should be playing this for Hayden Christensen.
Well, he's on base already, so they missed their chance.
I know.
Next time around.
Maybe. We'll see. Pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. Strike three called, and that'll retire the side before any damage can be done. Erdman gets out of the jam, and Xavier gets sent back to the dugout. We'll be back with the Cincinnati half of the third inning here in just a moment. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcast Sports Radio.
should be.
Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. Back at the top of the order for Cincinnati, Carrington Cross steps up to the plate, had a leadoff double in his first at bat. Was brought back in after home run hit by Hunter Jesse. Connor Bailey still on the mound for Xavier. Pitch on the way, swung on and hit fair down the third base line. Ooh. Carrington Cross has a chance for extra bases. He turns the corner at first, and he'll be sliding into second base. A nice hit there from Carrington Cross. Was unable to be tracked down by Hammond, just over his head and out of reach. And Cross
absolutely missed the play on that one.
He did. Cross back-to-back doubles. And his two times at bat brings up Josh Hageman to the plate for Cincinnati. He's 0 for 1. Flew out in the first inning. Great pace for Cincinnati here early. Pitch in the dirt for ball one. Ruckus showing out for this crosstown rivalry that still doesn't have a name, and I'm not sure how that's even possible at this point.
The crosstown series, I don't think it's that hard.
I mean, yeah.
Same thing as like the Subway Series, this is the same thing. Crosstown Series, everything in the UC Xavier rivalry is a crosstown.
Back pick to second, not in time.
And so it only makes sense that this one is the Crosstown Series.
Crosstown slug off.
No.
No, you don't like it.
I think Crosstown Series, simple, classic, very baseball.
Simple and classic, you heard it here first, folks. 1-0 the count after the back pick to second was not in time to try and get Carrington Cross, who stands in scoring position. Connor Bailey's back pick goes wild. Back in the center field, Carrington Cross takes off for third, and he'll be safe standing at third base.
That's really just unfortunate for Bailey. That was all the win, wasn't him. You could see it just fly away from the second baseman.
It almost looked like a curveball.
Yeah.
So now Carrington Cross 90 feet away. Josh Hageman with a chance for a sac fly early. No outs, 1-0 the count. Now imagine Carrington Cross tried to steal home plate.
I mean, if the ball gets past the catcher.
Pitch on the way, in between the gap of first and second base, and Josh Hageman standing with a single brings home Carrington Cross. Cincinnati retakes the lead 3-2.
Hageman has been very quietly a really good hitter for this team. He's not hitting the home runs like Josh Cross is, but he's been very solid.
Hageman, 41 hits on the year. 7 doubles on the year, and that brings up Josh Cross, the one who does hit the home runs and does it very, very well.
Very often.
Yesterday, hit a 441-footer. Josh Cross, who is 0 for 1 on the day, flew out to center his last at-bat, and is that pitch in the dirt for ball one. We should go get Dan Skillings and have him on. Have a little chat, a little interview. Nothing will beat our Dana Beers interview during the Crosstown Shootout last year. Hageman on first, pitch on the way, swung on, driven foul. And out of play. Way out of play. Cincinnati basketball falling in the quarterfinals of the NIT once again this year. Faced off against Indiana State. Falling that one. What many would say is a controversial game, but who's to say? Is that pitch over to first? Not in time. Trying to get the pickoff on Josh Hageman.
Xavier played Indiana State in baseball. Where's your connection?
There you go. I wasn't even going to try and connect the two. I was just talking about basketball because my connection is to talk about Dan Skillings. Just go get a picture with him. Just like that kid just did.
I think he's just trying to enjoy the,
I do too. I wouldn't bother. I'm 21 years old. Pickoff attempt not in time.
I'm not a kid. You know, I'm not going to try to steal a baseball from a kid. I'm not going to try to get, you know, annoy Dan Skillings. Like,
man, the shade in that first statement. That's crazy.
No shade. No
one won the count. This is a safe place. One won the count. Here, Josh Cross still at the plate. Winds and deals, swung on, hit between the gap of first and second once again. And that'll be a standing single for Josh Cross. And Josh Hageman is going to make his way to third. He'll stand 90 feet away. No outs for Cincinnati. Another well-hit ball by Cincinnati. And Hunter Jesse, who hit the first inning home run off at Fifth Third Arena, steps up to the plate. Chance to bring in two now. Hunter Jesse, the reason for the two runs. Steps up to the plate. It's an interesting batter stance as that pitch is way too close for comfort. Ball one. As called by home plate umpire Grady Smith. Josh Cross at first, Josh Hageman at second.
Third,
thank you. Bailey the pitch, inside the zone for strike one. I think someone's starting to chant down there. I'm not sure who or where or why down the third baseline.
The Bearcats are big chirpers.
Oh, always. They definitely are. Hunter Jesse popped with a tap up, and that one, Josh Cross is caught out at second base.
Probably should have been a double play ball there, but.
Definitely should have, but Cushing had fallen, couldn't quite collect himself quick enough. Was able to get Josh Cross out at second base, but not before Josh Hageman would make his way home. And Hunter Jesse would be safe standing at first base, which now leads Tommy O'Connor standing at home plate for Cincinnati. The pitch on the way inside, ball one, gets away from the catcher, is able to track it down and hold Hunter Jesse at first base. One of the count now. To Tommy O'Connor, who grounded out in the first inning, was the last out of that first inning. Has an on-base plus slugging over one, and he's one of two players with that honor, Josh Cross being the other, as Tommy O'Connor pops that one high into center field, going to track it down is Anderson. Anderson is able to make the grab for the second out of the bottom half of the third. Josh Cross coming into this game, 1.069 OPS. Tommy O'Connor, 1.047 OPS. Both those players combine for 23 home runs between the two. Now two outs for Loudon Brooks as he smacks this one high up into the air into center field. Anderson has a beat on it, makes his way up, makes the grab, retires the side, but not before Cincinnati can bring two more runs in and increase the lead back up to 4-2 as we head to the top half of the fourth. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcats Sports Radio. I just started with a song. There's no control. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. Cincinnati leading 4-2 over the Xavier Musketeers. Six hits to Xavier's three, and both teams have an error. As we head to the top half of the fourth inning. Mish up to the plate for the Musketeers. He was hit by pitch last time out. Makes him 0-0, technically speaking. But ESPN doesn't like that, so you don't put those on the graphics.
Nope.
Fun fact.
Just his walk.
This one was a hit by pitch. That pitch in the dirt for ball one. Which, I mean, makes sense that you wouldn't put 0-0.
I think that's an ESPN.
Issue,
not a general baseball one, because I've definitely seen it.
I don't think so either, but I feel like it makes sense to say that you're not 0-0 because you've technically had an at-bat.
But it doesn't count as your at-bat.
But it looks prettier if you just say hit by pitch. That pitch into the zone for ball two, or strike two. Oh, my goodness. Now I'm all distracted and things. Did that to myself. That's what I get for trying to tell a story. 1-2 the count. Erdman on the mound for Cincinnati. That pitch away for ball two. Was able to get out of a little bit of a jam last inning. The umpire calls time. Here was a soccer ball that made its way onto the field from Sheikley Lawn. Getting taken off the field. Designated hitter Connor Mish stands the pitch outside ball three. And it's really just been the wind. The wind is the problem. And you've seen it plenty of times already throughout this game as throws have gone wild. Back pick to second base just last half inning was costly for Xavier as that pitch is down and away for ball four. A six-pitch walk for Erdman. We'll send Mish to first base. He'll have reached for the second time today.
Still 0-0.
Brings up Hendrickson to the plate, the right fielder who's 0-1 on the day. Pitch on the way in the zone, strike one. The sound effects through the soundboard just remind me of my time interning with the Florence Gulls. That's all it does.
It's very minor league.
It is. Pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. Strike two. The only thing that Cincinnati is missing that the Florence Gulls had was that for opposing batters, they would play random songs that just were not serious at all. They would be Big Girls Don't Cry. Is that one swing and a miss? Strike three. Hendrickson gets sent back to the dugout by Erdman.
I feel like the NCAA would frown on.
Oh, definitely. Definitely, definitely.
They don't like anything fun in baseball.
No. Why would we have fun? Why would we celebrate? Why would we have props?
Why would we bat flip?
Yeah, why would we do anything fun?
Yeah.
At all? Why would we make sports fun? It's all about the money. MLS, pitch on the way, swung on and hit down the third base line. A nice throw there, no play at second. Play to first is in time. Will advance the runner, Mish, from first to second, but catch Lambden at first base. Brooks almost had the double play, but hesitated too hard. On the toss to second base, but will get one. It's Luke Hammond back to the top of the order for the Musketeers with two outs. Flew out in the first, struck out in the third. Did Hammond. See his runner in scoring position and Mish at second base. Pitch on the way, plunks him. And that, again, the wind. Hits him in the shoulder. It's a light pitch, suddenly 79 miles an hour. So wouldn't hurt too. I mean, I say that like I would know. I'm just some white guy that talks about sports for a living, but wouldn't hurt too bad. Maybe just a little bruise. Now two runners on for Xavier once again. Anderson to the plate, he swings. It's caught by the third baseman, fires to first in time, and that will retire the side as Anderson will get caught on the 5-3 putout, and that will send us to the bottom half of the fourth inning. Cincinnati leads 4-2 when we come back. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcast Sports Radio. Welcome back inside UC Baseball Stadium. Xavier has gone to the bullpen, pulls out Nolan Hughes in relief for their starting pitcher in Connor Bailey. Nolan Hughes, a Fordham transfer. Coming into this game for the Musketeers. Don't mind me as I'm struggling to find his name in the roster here. Split time between the weekend rotation and bullpen. Made 17 appearances. For Fordham, Halifax, Massachusetts native, a junior left-handed pitcher, will face off against Max Palmieri. Nolan Hughes 1-for-3 on the season, 16 innings pitched, 11 hits, 11 earned runs off 15 total runs. Palmieri, who's 0-for-1 on the day, is that pitch right down Broadway for strike one. Hughes has 30 punch-outs and a 6.19 ERA. A 2.5 whip. 0-1 count. Just inside the zone for strike two, and Palmieri didn't like that call. Kind of shook his head as he turned around.
These big foul bumps. So good.
That one tapped foul. Home plate umpire Grady Smith. First base Scott Wyckoff, second base Michael Ingram, and third base Justin Penix. 0-2 count for Palmieri. He's 0-for-1, grounded out in the second inning as that one dropped by the catcher Dupre. Makes the count 1-2. Palmieri, Sefcik, and Vitterick. Up for the Bearcats as that pitch high. Ball two. Palmieri is at the plate now. Sefcik on deck. Vitterick in the hole for Cincinnati. Count even at two. Palmieri smacks this down the third baseline, picked up by the third baseman. Fires to first base. High throw, caught in time. Catch Palmieri out. Hammond had a nice grab there, but a high throw to McCormick. McCormick able to wrangle that one down. Sends Palmieri back to the dugout, but brings out Luke Sefcik, who's one for one on the day. Had a single. Bottom half of the second inning. Scoreless inning for Cincinnati. Pitch on the way, high, ball one. One out the count now, one out. Nobody on for Cincinnati. Sefcik awaits the pitch. It's down and away for ball two. Down inside for ball two, excuse me. Nolan Hughes favoring that third base side of the rubber, looks to home with a wind the pitch inside the zone for strike one. The 2-1 pitch, tipped foul back into the backstop, popped up off concrete siding. Out of harm's way. Evens the count at two. For Luke Sefcik. Pitch on the way. Down, full count. 3-2. Trying to reach base for the second time today. Had a single in the top half, in the Bearcat half of the second. One of six hits Cincinnati has had. Pitch on the way. Down, and that will be a walk for Luke Sefcik, first of the day. His 11th walk of the season. We'll bring up Landon Vitterick, 0-for-1 on the day. Vitterick tied 6th in the Big 12. Stolen bases with 11. Steps up to the plate. That pitch in the zone for strike one. He has Sefcik on first base. He has 5 stolen bases on the year. 2 times he has been caught. Vitterick awaits the 0-1. Nolan looks to first. Then back home. Pitch on the way. Swung on and missed. Strike two. Nolan Hughes looking for the first Xavier strikeout on the day. Winds and deals, out, and he catches him looking. Landon Vitterick, strike three called. And just like that, spoken into existence. Second out for Xavier. Takes us back to the top of the order in Carrington Cross, who has one runner on in Luke Sefcik at first base. Carrington Cross, 2 doubles in this game already. First and third, respectively, was brought home both times. So almost identical situations for Carrington Cross, just hitting different sides of the field. Hughes the pitch inside, ball one. Was a little too close to Carrington Cross. That pitch on the way, down for ball one, ball two. Xavier only 57 hit batters on the year, has not had ones yet today. He's hit here bottom half of the fourth inning. Winds and deals inside, and Sefcik's gonna take off from first to second. No contest there. As Carrington Cross almost gets hit in the leg by Nolan Hughes. Hitters count now 3-0 for Carrington Cross. Cross looking to reach base for the third time today. We'll do so in back-to-back innings. Pitch on the way, strike one. It'll be the first time that this game that he has not reached via hit. Should he reach? On a 3-1 count, two outs. One runner on, it's Sefcik at second. Pitch on the way. In the zone, strike two. Runs the count full. Three, two count, two outs for Carrington Cross. He's two for two on the day, two doubles. Hughes looks to second, now back home. The pitch on the way, hit right back at him. Collected by the second baseman, third out of the first base, in time to McCormick, and that will retire the side before any damage can be done. Cincinnati still leads 4-2 as we head to the top half of the fifth inning. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcats Sports Radio. Welcome back inside UC Baseball Stadium. The Bearcats lead it 4-2 here as we head to the top half of the fifth inning. Xavier looking to cut back on the Cincinnati lead. Hayden Christensen now up to bat for the Bearcats. He's 0-1 on the day. Flew out in the first and a walk in the third. One of the first batters to see Erdman on the day as that pitch is away for ball one. One oh is the count. Pitch down away for ball two. It's Hayden Christensen. Looks to reach base for the second time today. Pitch in the zone. Four strike one. 91 mile an hour ball. It's been a good showing for Erdman. Three strikeouts, but three walks on the day as that pitch down and away for ball three. Three one. The count for Christensen. Erdman winds and deals. And a five-pitch walk for Hayden Christensen. And he'll be standing on first base. Second walk for him on the day. Fourth walk thrown by Drew Erdman. And Jordan Bischel is going to make his way out to have a little chat with Drew Erdman.
We'll see a pitching change here. Bischel doesn't come out a lot just to have a chat.
I'd missed if he had pointed over to the bullpen.
Oh, he took the ball.
Yep, looks like Erdman's day is done. After two innings of work, four walks, three strikeouts on the day, 12 batters face, 44 pitches. Now send Bearcats to the bullpen, and we'll talk about that new pitcher when we come back. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcats Sports Radio. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. Pitching change for Cincinnati. Joey Hirth makes his way out to the mound. Right-handed pitcher transfer from Indiana State makes his 12th appearance of the year for the Bearcats. 1-1 on the year so far. 11.2 innings pitched, 12 hits, 12 runs. 11 of them are earned, 11 strikeouts, and two home runs allowed on the year. He missed the majority of the 2023 season at Indiana State due to injury. Finished fifth in the MVC in 2022 as that pitch goes wild over the head of Josh Cross. Runners advance. Hayden Christensen makes his way to second base. After a high pitch from Joey Hirth. Hirth would finish fifth in the MVC and saves five and six in appearances of 25. Junior out of Hopkins, Minnesota. Pitch on the way, inside, ball two. Here's where we go deeper and deeper into this bullpen for Cincinnati. Is it here top of the fifth? Winds and deals Hirth way inside. Almost plunks Jared Cushing, who's up to bat for Xavier. One for two on the day, had a double in the second and flew out in the third. Winds the pitch in the zone. Four, strike one. As Hirth looks to turn this one around. Went down early. Wild pitch, advanced the runner. Second base, Hayden Christensen stands there. That one slapped down third baseline, foul. Full count now, 3-2. If you want a Reds update, the ninth, the Mariners lead Cincinnati Reds 5-1.
It's giving a sweep.
Sure is.
Speaking of sweeps, Joey Hirth was one of the UC pitchers to really get hit up last
check
weekend.
Swing. He went all the way around. Strike three called. Sorry to interrupt.
No, you're good. But as I was saying, Joey Hirth was one of the UC pitchers to really get hit up by Oklahoma State last week in that three-game loss. To the Cowboys.
That was a good, and as much as that series looked painful for Cincinnati, it was also a testament to how Cincinnati can compete as that one swung on and missed. Strike one called to McCormick, who just stepped up to bat, grounded out in the second, walk in the third. But Cincinnati was able to hold their own for a lot of time against Oklahoma State on Friday and Sunday. Pitch on the way, swung on and hit foul. Quickly 0-2 the count, but Bearcats took the Cowboys to extras on Friday and fought for a lead early and throughout on Sunday. Saturday was a little bit of a wash for the Bearcats against the Cowboys, but it just proves that Cincinnati has the will to compete as that one slapped by McCormick down in the center field. A beat is had on it by Hegeman. Hegeman at the warning track looks up, watches it go over the wall, and that one is gone. Ties things up back at four. Two-run home run for Matt McCormick. Brings home Christensen, who was standing at second base. Now one out for Cincinnati. That home run is hit, and if you're going to have no fun, then why are they out there doing their home run celebration? But that's neither here nor there.
We do our home run celebration, too.
Oh, I know. I know.
But going back to what you were saying, that yeah, UC can compete, but it's against those ranked teams that it really shows that they're not quite where I think where Jordan Mitchell wants them to be.
Bunt down for Dupre. Had a nice bunt. It lost all its momentum right in front of home plate. Josh Cross had to get up, grab it, and launch it to first base to O'Connor, who had the stretch and caught it in time. Caught the second out. But it is a good point that you are making against these ranked teams. It is difficult, and Cincinnati has a shot to be there eventually. And in Jordan Bischel's first year, it's not looking bad.
It's much better than everybody thought.
Pitch on the way, high, four ball one. And I mean, obviously, you look at the preseason poll, Cincinnati picked to finish last in the preseason poll, is fighting towards the middle of the table currently, and it was as high as third place at one point, that pitch in the zone, strike one. But the Big 12 also just a highly competitive conference in baseball, as they are in many a thing.
Yeah.
Basketball, I mean, both of the men's and women's variety, soccer, softball. That one tapped down to the shortstop. He has a grab on it. Launched to first is in time. A 6-3 put out, and Cincinnati retires the side, but not before the Musketeers can tack on two more and tie things back up at four. We come back the bottom half of the fifth inning. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcats Sports Radio. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. Josh Hegeman to lead off the home half of the fifth inning. Cincinnati and Xavier tied at four here in the Crosstown Series as dubbed by Kira. Pitch on the way, high for ball one. Nolan Hughes still on the mound for Xavier. One walk, one strikeout in his one inning pitched. He's faced four batters. Pitch on the way to Hegeman. Low for ball two. Two of the count, no outs. Here's Hegeman leads it off for Cincinnati. He's a 1-for-2 on the day. Had a single in the third with an RBI tacked onto it. And was brought back home as that pitch low for ball three. Another thing I'll say about this time of year, allergies are not fun. Forgot my Zyrtec. Pitch on the way. Almost plunks Hageman. We'll send him to first base on the four-pitch walk. Josh Hageman reaches base for the second time today, and Josh Cross makes his way to the plate. Flew out in the first and a single in the third. Just to reach base one more time. Here, bottom half of the fifth inning. Josh Hageman, who is a speedster, stands on first base, pitch on the way, check swing. He went 0-1 the count. Hageman with 9 stolen bases, caught twice. It's an 81.8 stolen base percentage on the year. Pitch on the way, in the zone, strike two. Quickly down the count is Josh Cross, who struck out 20 times this season amidst his 48 hits. Wind the deal. Check swing. Did he go? He did not. Was able to catch it just in time. It'll be ball one on the 1-2 count for Josh Cross. Hageman takes a couple steps off the bag. Nolan looks to first, decides not to throw, throws it to home plate instead on the pitch inside, ball two. The wind is taking our tablecloth away.
It's trying to.
It wants it. Down even at two, no outs, one runner on for Cincinnati. It's Hageman at first base. The pitch on the way. Inside, ball three. Runs the count full. Cincinnati trying to reclaim the lead after Xavier had brought in two runs in the top half of the fifth inning. We sit here tied at four. Very back and forth game so far between these two rivals. That one tipped foul.
As you kind of expected, they're pretty evenly matched teams, you know. Xavier's 3-3 in the Big East right now. UC has a slightly better record in the Big 12, but, you know, they're pretty evenly matched.
Xavier also a multi-time offender in the NCAA tournament, excuse me. Is that pitch high and a 7-pitch walk for Josh Cross sends him to first base with no outs.
Yes.
Now two runners on.
Xavier went to the tournament last year after winning the Big East tournament.
They fell in the first round, then came back in the losers round, but then would lose to Oregon.
They had a pretty tough group.
They did. They very much did. The NCAA tournament for baseball is no joke. Hunter Jesse steps up to the plate. He's 1-for-2 on the day. The home run, the sack flies. That pitch way up.
Nolan Hughes is throwing them very close to UC batters.
Sending a message is Hughes, and looks like skipper Billy O'Connor is going to make his way over to the mound. Nolan Hughes have a quick talking to. No calls on the bullpen. Flappy Bird plays on the video board here in UC Baseball Stadium. I thought that was taken off the App Store. Well, an update for all your Bundesliga fans. Bayern Munich wins on aggregate 1-0 against Arsenal.
Yeah, so many Bundesliga fans tuning into the UC.
So many Bundesliga fans that aren't me and you.
Yeah. So many people who care about that score that aren't us.
So many people. But hey, you never know. It's not like we're talking about some lower level league in Germany. People know what the Bundesliga is. Is that pitch in the zone for strike one?
If you want to watch lower division soccer, the Open Cup's on all night tonight. All games are available for free on ussoccer.com and the Open and mlssoccer.com. So.
Shameless plug. Not that you work for
it. Not that I work for the Open Cup,
but we do support the Open Cup here.
Cup.
We do support the Open Cup here on this broadcast. That pitch fouled off. One and two the count.
If you want to watch a little bit of lower division soccer, there you go.
Especially since the MLS decided that they wanted to take their first teams out of the Open Cup competition, which is...
Most of them, anyway.
Most of them, yes, but still a shame. Especially for our home club, FC Cincinnati. That's a huge blow to that scheduling. That one tipped foul down the first baseline into the camera well.
I mean, yeah, it just meant a lot to FC Cincinnati, that 2017 run. That's a big reason why they're in MLS now, so...
I will be purchasing a scarf that says Save the Open Cup, and it says something else on the back. I can't remember what it is, and I can't remember if I can actually say it on air. 1-2 the count to Hunter Jesse, working against Nolan Hughes. Jesse ready in the box. Hughes ready on the mound. Looks to second now, home, pitch on the way, swing and a miss. That'll be strike three called. Said Hunter Jesse back to the dugout, and Tommy O'Connor steps up to the plate with one of the best walkout songs that I think I've heard all day.
His secondary walkout song.
It is. It's a good one. It should be his primary. Tommy O'Connor.
Hunter Jesse also has a good walkout song.
He does. He does. Connor 0-2.
Domingo, which is the song that plays pregame at FC Cincinnati.
Yes, I noticed that. Pitch in the zone, strike one to Tommy O'Connor. He's 0-2, grounded out in the first, flew out in the third. One out, two runners on. It's Josh Cross at first and Josh Hegeman at second. Pitch on the way, swing and a miss for Tommy O'Connor. My goodness. Wind is brutal. Blowing in, I think there's a chance of rain tomorrow night, I think is the system that's coming, if I remember correctly. Oh, he looked for a first pitch today. Pitch on the way, swing and a miss. Tommy O'Connor gets sent back to the dugout. Another punch out for Nolan Hughes will be his third. That brings up Loudon Brooks. Up to the plate for Cincinnati. Brooks over two on the day so far. It's 0.311 batting average. With two runners on, two outs. It's a 0.125 with two outs. Pitch on the way, inside, ball one. Brooks on the ground out and a fly out in the second and third, respectively. Hughes, the pitch, inside the zone for strike one. Brooks looking for a spark here for Cincinnati. For the first time this game, they've been shut out in back-to-back innings. Count runs 1-2. Scored two in the first, none in the second, two in the third, none in the fourth. So they sit here tied with Xavier 4-4. Hughes the pitch, swing and a miss. Punches out Loudon Brooks. And that will retire the side and send us to the top half of the sixth inning. Xavier looks to take the lead for the first time today when we come back. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcast Sports Radio. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. Tied up at four are the Bearcats and the Musketeers. This is Scoreboard Stumper. I wasn't paying attention. I was looking at Twitter.
Yep, no clue.
Oh, well. Should find a trivia question about something.
For all dozens of the listeners.
Yeah.
All 12.
Yeah. Big 12.
All right.
Joey Hurst still stands on the mound for Cincinnati, facing off against Carter Hendrickson, who's 0-for-2 on the day. Put out a strikeout as that one popped up and foul off the awning. Josh Cross makes his way over to catch it off the ricochet, but obviously will not count. It'll be 0-1 is that count. Oh, I feel like I constantly feel like I'm about to sneeze. 0-1 pitch, swung on and hit over the head of Joey Hurst. Shortstop comes over to collect and will fire it over to first base in time. Loudon Brooks screaming in from his spot over in left field. Fires it over to Tommy O'Connor. Finds the first out of the top half of the sixth. That's another thing, too, about some of these new rules and the pitch clock and everything is that these games fly if they are played the right way.
Yeah, well, I remember that almost five-hour game we sat through against Western Illinois.
I remember my five-and-a-half-hour game where both bullpens emptied between Cincinnati and East Carolina 2 years ago here at UC Baseball Stadium. I had the call on that one, and I had to work immediately after that up at Insomnia Cookies off on Calhoun Street, and I had to text my manager and be like, hey, I'm going to be late. I got to call a baseball game. Pitch on the way. Swung on, driven high up into center field. With a beat on it is Josh Hegeman, who's moving over to his right. Makes the catch for the second out. But that was a rough one. I mean, it felt like every other pitch there was a mound meeting, and then every inning there was a call to the bullpen. And what I mean, it was a Sunday rubber match, so, you know, you could if you really wanted to, but they went through almost every single pitcher. It was an interesting event to have witnessed, and sometimes to think about that.
That's the last thing you want on a Sunday
game. Oh, yeah.
Just go through your whole bullpen. I mean, Sunday games, especially for the visiting team, you just want to get out.
It's your getaway game. No need to stay. Hammond up to the plate, 0-for-2, hit by pitch, struck out, and flew out. Pitch on the way from Hurst, outside, ball two. That's the thing here, too, for Xavier, that their upcoming schedule. Believe they'll be back on the road. Is that pitch outside the zone for ball three?
Yeah, they're back on the road this weekend to Seton Hall.
Yeah, and they'll come back to Ohio, face off at Miami, Ohio, then welcome NKU to Hayden Field.
Yeah, they'll
that pitch way up and high almost hits Hammond.
Oh, they did hit him.
And it looks it'll be a four-pitch walk for Hammond. Hammond just barely able to get out of the way before it maybe grazed his helmet. A scary one there, 90-mile-an-hour pitch. Almost to the face of Hammond. That moves him up to first base. Anderson now stands in the batter's box working against Joey Hurst. Pitch almost same spot. Ball one. Anderson grounded out in the first and fourth, reached on an error in the third. Pitch on the way in the zone, strike one. Evens the count at one. Top of the sixth inning, both teams tied at four. That pitch in the zone for strike two. Hammond looked like he wanted to take off from first. Elected not to after the strike was called. Did not want to challenge Cross on his throw to second. Hurst winds and the pitch thrown. Tap, check, swing. He went all the way. That'll be the last out of the top of the sixth inning. Bottom of the sixth we go here in Cincinnati. tied up at 4. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcast Sports Radio. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium, all wrapped up at 4 as we head to the bottom half of the sixth inning. Kira Campbell, Ethan Herzog with you here on Bearcast Sports Radio, student voice of the Cats, and I'm going to try and coin that. Maybe. I'll talk to Chase and Aiden about that one.
Yeah.
Since they're in charge now, I'm only in charge for about 3 weeks, and then I'm out. Peace. Deuces. See you later.
I've already stopped being in charge.
Oh, I know. I know. So not really. I'm still handling all the paperwork, reaching out the SIDs and trying to get credentials that I've heard from IU, so we'll be heading to IU. Be the second road trip. No, the third road trip for Bearcast Sports Radio as we covered the Louisville match that midweek, and co-director Preston Baker was in St. Louis for whatever reason. He covered the three-game series against the Billikens.
The only coverage they had.
It was.
I think Sunday they had a broadcast, but
for the most part, it was just
the rest
us.
Rest of the week, just us.
Max Palmieri now into the box for Cincinnati. Pitch on the way.
Against new Xavier pitcher Nick Boyle.
And Nick Boyle, who entered, he's 3-4 on the year. 34.1 innings pitched, 37 hits, 24 runs. 23 of them are earned with 43 strikeouts on the year. Pitch on the way, swing and a miss for Max Palmieri. Evens the count at 1. Take a closer look at Nick Boyle. He's a Goshen, Kentucky native. Senior right-handed pitcher. Winds and deals in the zone, strike 2. Didn't make an appearance until 2023, where he made 13, including 5 starts. What helped Xavier to the 2024 Big East Tournament Championship. That one swung on and hit into the gap between second and third in the center, and Max Palmieri is on base for the first time today on a single. A nice piece of hitting there from Max Palmieri. Says hello to Nick Boyle. .92 off the bat. Brings up Luke Sefcik. 1-for-1 on the day. Single and a walk in the second and fourth. Now has one runner on, no outs, and Max Palmieri. Pitch on the way. High, ball 1. Winds and deals for the second pitch. Outside, 4-2. First time that Boyle has faced off against Cincinnati this year. Saw action most recently against Creighton. That pitch on the way, high, 3. Quickly, 3-0. Saw action in the win against LSU. Pitched 5 innings in that one, 4 hits and a run. That pitch on the way, for ball four and a four pitch walk for Luke Sefcik. Quickly, two runners on, no outs for the Bearcats. And in comes the nine spot in Landon Vitterick, 0 for 2. On the day, and now a meeting of the minds makes their way out. Jordan Bischel's also going to make his way out.
Going to have an offensive chat.
Want to talk with third base coach and bring in.
Might as well take the opportunity base. When they're talking on the mound.
Free timeout, if you will.
I don't think it counts against you if you take it while they came out first. So.
Xavier's meeting's done, and just like that, Cincinnati's meeting wraps up. Jordan Bischel's going to head back to the dugout. Saw Jordan Bischel yesterday, actually, post game.
Really?
Yeah, he was walking to his car as I was walking to my car at Varsity Village Garage. Yeah, I almost said hi, but I was like, I don't want to be weird.
Hey, coach.
He doesn't know who I am.
He doesn't know who I am. I work for him, so.
You don't work for him. You work for Coach Sheriff.
Same thing.
Yeah, fair enough. Landon Vitterick in the box now for Cincinnati. Struck out looking as that bunt is up and foul.
Foul ball.
Oh, and one the count is there's the Wii Sports sound effects that we know and love. Still haven't found Wii Sports. I bought a Wii and I cannot find Wii Sports for cheap enough that I'm willing to pay for. I'm not paying $50 for Wii Sports. I want to count to Vitterick. Pitch on the way. Swung on. Swinging and foul ball down the third base line. Line drive into the stands, and about 20 people got up and got out of the way. Now quickly an 0-2 count for Landon Vitterick. Looking to keep his at-bat alive. Swings the bat over his head. Boyle looks to second. Now the pitch. High, ball one. 1-0, 1-2 is the count. Two runners on. Sefcik at first, Palmieri at second. Sefcik has 5 stolen bases on the year. Palmieri has 0. Pitch on the way. Swung on, driven into the gap between first and second. Double play, loading. Got one, and no play at first base. Sefcik caught out at second base. Vitterick safe at first, and Max Palmieri will advance to third. So now we're on our 90 feet away. An easy scoring position for the Bearcats, and Carrington Cross makes his way up to the plate for the fourth time today. Musketeers weren't able to efficiently execute that double play, but had the opportunity. 7 hits now for the Bearcats as Carrington Cross steps up. 2 doubles back-to-back in the first and third, and a ground out the fourth. The back pick to third is not in time. Looks like it knocked the third baseman for Xavier and Hammond. It's like training staff coming out to take a look. Hammond looks like he's able to get up okay, maybe just a little shaken up there. Wasn't expecting a back pick from Dupre. He's looking to get checked out by the athletic training staff of Xavier. And if he needs to, he can go to Cincinnati Medical Center. Not too far from here. There are about 7 hospitals in the Clifton area. He does look to be okay as he heads back to his bag. To the applause of the fans here at UC Baseball Stadium. Back to it here, Carrington Cross with a 1-0 count, 1 out, 2 runners on in the corners. Pitch on the way, shows bunt. Vitterick slides in the second and he'll be safe on the steal opportunity. And another steal for Landon Vitterick. It'll be his 13th on the year. Duncan stolen base.
Cincinnati cheetah.
I love cheetahs. Cheetos. Not really. Cheetos are all right. Time called over on third base. Looks like Hammond's having a little bit of trouble here. He's talking to the third base umpire, Justin Penix. Waves on. Looks like he'll be okay. Now a 2-0 count for Carrington Cross. Two runners on. Vitterick advances to second. Palmieri still at third. Pitch on the way in the zone for strike one. Carrington Cross hits at a .357 clip with runners in scoring position. .379 with runners on. Currently sits with a 2-1 count with one out. Going to drive home some runs, reclaim the lead here for Cincinnati. Swung on and hit over to the second baseman on a liner. We'll keep the runners at second and third and claim the second out for Carrington Cross. We'll bring up Josh Hegeman. Hegeman, who's 1-for-2 on the day, has now eclipsed a .400 batting average on the season. One of the highest in the Big 12. Two outs now, two runners on for Cincinnati. Hegeman takes ball one. Against Nick Boyle, who is 2/3 of innings, currently only allowed one hit, one walk. That one low, ball two. Trying to strand two runners on. It's Nick Boyle. Face four batters up to this point. The pitch outside, but called strike. 2-1 the call. Due up for Xavier, Hayden Christensen, Jared Cushing, and Matt McCormick. One, the half inning is over. That one outside, ball three. So this looks like a makeup call from the home plate umpire. They're calling a pitch from that same spot, a strike. Boiled the pitch. It'll be a five-pitch walk. Loads the bases for Cincinnati, and Hegeman goes and stands on first. And that brings up Josh Cross.
The Bearcats home run hitter.
Josh Cross with his 13 home runs on the season. The last grand slam hit by a Bearcat, Ryan Nicholson, on May 18th of 2023 at Houston.
Houston will be in town this weekend.
Three-game series starting on Friday, Saturday and Sunday. Pitch on the way, swung on and tipped foul. And you know he wants it.
Oh, absolutely.
Josh Cross taking his time. Now steps into the box, taps home plate twice. He sits in the box. Pitch from Boyle on the way, outside ball two, ball one, excuse me. Josh Cross readies in the box. Boyle does the same. Pitch on the way, outside ball three. Ball two, excuse me. I'm not sure where I am in the count. Ball two, it's a 2-1 count, two outs. Run, bases are loaded. Hegeman at first, Vitterick at second, Palmieri at third. Josh Cross stands in the bat for Cincinnati. Boyle winds and deals. High, ball three. Josh Cross back to it, a good duel here. The pitch on the way, swung on, driven down the first baseline, but foul. Some good contact, just a little late. The 87 mile an hour pitch. Josh Cross with a chance to open this one up. Cross ready, Boyle on the first base side of the rubber. Deals, swung on, driven down the first base line, caught by McCormick. He's going to race to first base, tap him out, and that will retire the side before any damage can be done. We're all tied up at four, heading to the top half of the seventh inning. You're listening to Bearcat Baseball here on Bearcat Sports Radio. Welcome back inside UC Baseball Stadiums. We're all wrapped up here at four. Joey Hurst still on the mound for Cincinnati. Hayden Christensen on deck for the Musketeers. Musketeers looking to claim the season series win against the Cincinnati Bearcats. Bearcats have, like make all other sports, have been facing off against the Xavier Musketeers for a long, long time. Dating all the way back to their first meeting back in 1906. Listed as a 10-2 win for Cincinnati as that pitch inside for ball one. Cincinnati leads the all-time series, 102 wins to 66 losses and two ties.
Two ties.
Pitch on the way, swung on and hit over to the shortstop, a light dribbler over to first base in time. Tommy O'Connor making the catch. Hayden Christensen out back to the dugout. Up comes Cushing for the Musketeers. Yeah, there are a handful of ties in baseball. I'm not sure how it's even possible, but it is. There's a team that has a tie right now, and I don't remember which one it is, but it's in the Big East. I think it might be St. John's. St. John's might have a tie.
It's possible. I think if it goes on for so many extra innings, they just call it after a while.
Pitch on the way, strike one. I think it was a doubleheader that first game went its normal length, and the second game went to seven, and they called it after seven.
That's weird.
Pitch on the way, swing and a miss, strike two.
Usually the first game is the seventh inning, and you play the full game, the second one.
Maybe there was some kind of weather problem.
That's possible, too, and they just called it a tie.
I didn't do too much investigation. I just saw that it happened. Pitch on the way, outside for ball one. And another thing I will say about this long-standing rivalry, especially in baseball, is why are we not playing games at Great American Ballpark? It's definitely a good venue. Is that one tip foul? Obviously, you know, you're not going to sell out the entire stadium. It's 44,000 seats that, you know, I do not think that you would be able to get, but you'd still get a decent amount. Last time, the last and only time these two teams played at Great American Ballpark, they sold about 500 tickets. Good chunk of the lower bowl was sold. That one's tipped foul down the third baseline.
I think the problem is you can't. If you were trying to sell enough tickets to make it worth playing at Great American, you couldn't play it on a weekday.
No, you'd have to play that on a Saturday.
Saturdays, the weekends are usually reserved for series, and because of the closeness of UC and Xavier, they don't ever play series. So they can schedule two midweeks, you know, one at the start of the season, one at the end, so. logistically, it would be hard.
Swing and a miss, strike three called. Down goes Jared Cushing, second out of the inning.
Noises.
And the dolphin noises. I feel like I'm watching an episode of SpongeBob.
I don't get that.
I know you don't. McCormick steps up to the plate now, first baseman for Xavier. Shift is on for Cincinnati. So I guess the shift hasn't been banned in college ball.
It has not.
Which I was not aware of. I thought they had taken it away.
I think they're more concerned with getting these games over with.
Probably. First pitch outside for ball one.
Especially
one
like
of the count.
College ball. Sometimes it's just difficult to get an out.
Which is fair.
Pitching's bad. The metal bats makes it go way further than it needs to, you know.
True. Ball down for ball two.
I don't think they're in the business of getting rid of anything that creates more outs. It makes the games go by a little bit faster.
A fair point.
Even with the pitch clock, college games take a long time.
That one high for ball three. And I feel like if you're going to speed up the game, why take the shift away from the majors?
Because the majors wanted a better TV product to make it more entertaining.
Fair point. Money. Money's fun.
Nobody's making money off of college baseball.
Fair point. Swing and a drive into right field. A beat on it is had by Vitterick. Grabs that one. Third out of the inning, and now we'll retire the side. Send us to the bottom of the seventh. Time to stretch here in Cincinnati. We'll be back in just a few minutes. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcast Sports Radio.
Gillette Catholic.
Bearcats have made a call to the bullpen here in Cincinnati. Number 12, Alex Vera, graduate student out of Joliet, Illinois. Attended Joliet Catholic. Left-handed pitcher, went 1-for-1 with a 5.74 ERA at Illinois. He's a transfer in from such school. Struck out 33 batters and had 10 walks. 20 appearances were third most on the team, and his 33 strikeouts were fifth most among Illini relievers. Serious question, what is an Illini?
A person who lives in Illinois.
Is that a genuine statement?
Yeah. It's the same thing, that's a Hoosier, somebody who lives in Indiana.
Oh yeah, I guess that's right. Yeah. More you know.
It's the same thing, same concept.
No, there's here's your song.
It's a good song. It's a good
for Hunter
song.
Jesse.
It's different. I like it.
It is. It is. It is a good one.
It's not a country song. So.
No, it's not.
Here on Country Music Night.
Country Music Night here in UC Baseball Stadium. And a couple of good ones, a couple of bad ones. I'm not very much a fan of Luke Bryan, but fan of some of the older stuff that's being played. This Hunter Jesse takes strike one. 1-for-3 on the day. Hit home run with two RBIs attached to that one. Flew out and struck out. A sack fly in the third and a strikeout in the fifth. Pitch on the way in the zone, strike two. We'll say we can say that we know what a Bearcat is.
Bearcat. Binturong.
It's a binturong. It's an Asian animal. Looks like a cross between a bear and a cat.
Very cute.
Quite literally. That one taken, ball one. 1-2 is the count.
But what is a blob?
Not real. Not real. Luckily, these aren't the Xavier Blobs. They're the Xavier Musketeers. The Musketeers are real
yeah,
for their favor.
Yeah, but their other mascot is a blob.
That one outside for 2-2. So we just casually talk smack about Xavier's mascot, but we are a home broadcast, so we can. We're allowed.
Student broadcast.
Yeah. Exactly. We're a home student broadcast. We're allowed. We just got to keep it clean, keep it PG. Pitch on the way. Swung on and tapped over to the second baseman. Light toss over to first base is in time. It'll catch Hunter Jesse out at first base for the first out of the bottom half of the seventh inning. The blob reminds me of Gritty, the Flyers mascot.
I don't like
In the concept of weird imaginary things.
I don't like Gritty, so.
Gritty is a little scary.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a little terrifying.
I'm not a big mascot person in general. They're a little scary.
Tommy O'Connor tips that one foul. First pitch he sees. 0-1 the count. I mean, that's fair.
Like, if you've ever seen the pictures of the old Brutus the Buckeye.
Oh, terrifying.
Terrifying.
Absolutely terrifying.
The current one's scary.
The current one is scary, but a little bit less scary.
Yeah. But the old ones, that's just a nut.
When you personify certain things, it just
like
makes
a
it a little scary. Yes. Pitch on the way. Swung on and hit right back at the pitcher. It was between the gap of first and second base. Coming on to make the play is Cushing. Throws into McCormick at first base in time. It'll catch Tommy O'Connor out at first base for the second out of the bottom half of the seventh. Now Lawton Brooks steps up to the plate. Brooks 0 for 3. Another good walk-up song, Mr. Jones. Also a good one.
Alec Jones should have had this. That's his walk-up song.
I agree.
Be
However,
fitting.
Loudon Brooks does. Still a good song.
Loudon Brooks, big ice chai guy.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Straight ice chai.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Big ice chai guy.
Takes ball one. For anyone that doesn't know, we both work at Starbucks, just different ones.
I work at the one up on the campus on Calhoun Street, so I know all of the athletes' orders. Dan Skillings, big pumpkin spice guy.
Mr. Pumpkin Spice himself. I've made that reference on a broadcast before. That pitch down for ball two. I actually have Ariel Jackson's Starbucks order on my phone. I don't remember why, but I do.
Delaney Snyder gets the most basic, stuff.
That one popped foul down the first baseline. Is it an ice white mocha with vanilla cold foam and caramel drizzle?
It sure is.
How did I know? Got to get her hooked on the new spicy refresher.
Ew.
I don't know, man. I'm just waiting for the summer launch of the white macadamia. That's going to be fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
Pitch on the way. Outside ball three. 3-1 the count, nobody on, two outs for Cincinnati. Loudon Brooks, who's 0 for 3, ground out, fly out, strikeout, all in that order in the second, third, and fifth. As we digress here from our Starbucks conversation.
Get back into the game.
3-1 the count. Down and ball four called, a five-pitch walk for Loudon Brooks, sends him trotting on over to first base.
Time to lock back in.
Hey, man, this could be what Anthony Mazzini and Andy Nagel had last year, where they were talking about flex tape.
I mean, Billy had a shades on the Rock House yesterday.
Sure did. But I feel like Billy's allowed to have that on. Former big leaguer. He's earned it.
Yeah.
He's all right. Max Palmieri steps into the box now, 1 for 3 on the day. Single in the sixth. Pitch on the way inside. Ball one.
Hit him.
Oh, it hit him. Z takes off running to first base. Now two runners on for Cincinnati. Those will haunt.
Hopefully, you see, you can turn this into a run, so we're not here for extras.
Luke Sefcik steps up to the plate now for Cincinnati, who is 1 for 1 on the day. For the Bearcats now, as two runners on. Brooks at second, Palmieri at first base. Sefcik with a single in the second, then two walks back-to-back in the fourth and sixth. Take strike one. 0-1 is the count now. Vera looks back to second, now back home. Pitch on the way, and it's ball one. I told you the Andy Nick comes into my Starbucks, right?
No.
He does. I don't know what I think he just gets a plain pike. That's it, though. Pitch on the way, swung on, tap foul backwards into the construction area. Yeah, former director of operations comes into my Starbucks and gets a pike place with. It's either black or he gets it with like oat milk or something. One of the two.
Interesting.
Sounds like it. 1-2 the count now. Juan Sefcik. Vera looks the second now back home. Pitch on the way, tap foul. Back into the backstop. Now a three-person booth for ESPN Plus. Anthony Mazzini, Billy Hatcher, and Zach Siegel, former Bearcat, all in the booth today. Billy Hatcher and Zach Siegel alternating from time to time. Dan Pizzini holding down the play-by-play duties as that one brings up strike three. Retires the side, sends us to the top half of the eighth inning, tied up at four. Cincinnati baseball here on Bearcat Sports Radio when we come back. Welcome back inside UC Baseball Stadium. Pitching change for Cincinnati. Sophomore Tommy Boba makes his way in to the mound. And I mean, I assume to warm up for this weekend, I assume that he'll probably be taking on Houston one of the 3 days, probably a Saturday start for Tommy Boba coming up.
Yeah, I think so. He's usually been a starter for our weekend series. He's done pretty well. So I assume he's just getting a couple innings of work in before that.
12 starts and 14 appearances last season. 2-1 record with a 6.27 ERA. Second on the staff in starts with 12. And fourth in strikeouts with 43. And innings pitch with 47.1. Almost had a no-hitter against Kansas. However, the bunt was applied to end the no-hitter, and it still makes me mad to this day. I'm still better.
Soft from Kansas.
Truth. The last no-hitter thrown by a Bearcat was 1995. Tommy Boba almost had one.
I had the graphic ready and everything.
Sure did. I was directing, and I was so ready to call that show. Boba winds, deals inside the zone for strike one, 85 miles an hour, right down Broadway. It's count 0-1 against Matthew Dupre, 1-for-3 on the day. A single was brought back home in the second. That one tapped lightly back to the catcher, Josh Cross. No play as it is called foul by the home plate umpire, Grady Smith. It's the third time today that a ball has lost its momentum and just tapped home plate and stayed foul. Makes the count 0-2 against Matthew Dupre. Tommy Boba looks, deals, swing and a miss. Strike three called. That sends Matthew Dupre back to the dugout and brings up Mr. Mish.
Designated hitter, number one, Connor Mish.
For Xavier, Connor Mish. 0 for 1 on the day, hit by pitch, a walk, and a ground out in the fifth inning. Pitch on the way, down and away for ball one. 1-0. It's the count to Connor Mish.
You know, it makes sense bringing Boba in here. It's reliable. You're pretty sure you're going to keep the score tied. Better bet than some of your other bullpen pieces, and it gives them a chance to get warmed up before the weekend.
Just a nice little warm-up. Only got two innings left here. Two out of the count now. Pitch on the way. Strike one called. That one sits just inside the strike zone. Two-one pitch.
Oh.
Plunks him. Announcer's jinx is real.
Yeah.
Tommy Boba goes and hits Connor Mish, sends him trotting his way on over to first base. Brings up Carter Hendrickson, who's 0 for 3 on the day. To work against Tommy Boba. Boba coming into the day, 3 for 4, 42 innings pitched, 39 hits allowed, 33 runs, 31 of which are earned. Strike one called on the most recent pitch with 39 strikeouts on the year as well. Boba looks to first, now gets set. Looks to home, the 0-1, swung on, tip foul. As Mish takes off for first base, but will be sent backwards. Turning it, other than the wind, turns out to be a nice day, which, I mean, it's truly a Midwestern statement, but.
Good weather. I mean, even with the wind, it's still really warm.
Ball hasn't cooperated, but that's no to nobody's fault for the most part. Boba's pitch, check swing, he did not go. Much to the displeasure of the Bearcat faithful in the dugout. Brings the count to 1-2. Josh Cross really wanted that check swing, and he did not go. Henderson looking to keep his at bat alive. The 0-2 on the way. Outside, ball one. Ball two, excuse me. Windy, windy, windy day. Count even a 2 with one out. Runner on first, it's Mish. Tommy Boba, the pitch. Swung on and slapped deep down the third base line. And that ball is foul.
That would have been gone if it had stayed there.
That had plenty of carry, just went to the left side of the foul pole.
Would have interrupted that soccer game on Sheikley Lewis.
Hopefully everybody's okay. Hopefully nobody got hit. But, free souvenir. The umpires are converging now.
Well, they might go review this, see if it went fair or not.
I sure hope not. Spoken as a true Bearcat fan. They sit just to the left of the mound. Discussing what happened just now. Looks like there's also a bag over on the warning track blowing around. This will go to review.
Yep, they're
going to
go take a look.
Call on the field currently stands as a foul ball hit down the third base line.
I mean, it was hard to tell. I mean, the sun is wearing right in from there, too. So
does not help matters whatsoever. But as they take a break to review, so will we. We'll be back when the call is made. You're listening to Bearcat Baseball here on Bearcat Sports Radio. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. And it has been confirmed, a home run for Xavier off the bat of Hendrickson. A two-run shot to left. Huge blow for Cincinnati.
Harrington Cross is not happy about that call. Look at him.
Now it looks like Jordan Bischel is giving the ump an earful.
Jordan Bischel's going to be terrible. He might get himself ejected.
He might get thrown.
He's back on the field again.
Home plate umpire Grady Smith currently paying no attention.
Doing a good job of ignoring him.
Xavier takes a two-run lead 6-4 over Cincinnati after the review of the home run. Now the ump back having another conversation with the Cincinnati dugout. Now back to it. Tommy Boba facing off now against Lambden. Swung on and hit foul down the third base line. I mean, that's a tough call for anybody, as any camera that would have that angle is shooting into the sun.
Yeah, that's the problem, I think, with the
pitch on the way in the zone.
Is the umpire is staring straight into the sun to make that call.
No one can see that. But the thing is, if you don't have clear, definitive evidence, then you can't overturn that call.
I mean, we didn't see the replays, but I'm sure they, whatever camera caught that, was pretty clear. Otherwise, I don't think they'd overturn it.
1-2 the count now. That one tipped foul back into the backstop. I mean, obviously, yeah, we have no way of telling. We don't have any monitors in front of us. We do not have that luxury, unfortunately.
And they didn't show the replays out here because it wasn't beneficial to UC. So.
No, they definitely would not. They would not do that. And I don't know if they can anyway due to inciting the crowd. I have no idea how the NCAA stands on that one. As that one hit deep into center field, going back to grab it, and a nice grab. Back deep in the outfield for Hunter Jesse. Able to make the grab. And Lambden, who was standing at second base, pleading his case, is going to get sent back to the dugout by second base umpire Michael Ingram. And that brings up Luke Hammond to the top of the order for Xavier. Tommy Boba winds, deals, outside ball one. Things seem to have calmed down over in the Cincinnati side of the dugout. Boba swinging a miss. Strike one called on Luke Hammond. For the first time that Jordan Bischel will get thrown out if he were to have kept going, but I think he'd decided to quiet down as that one hit over the third baseman, over to first in time. That'll be the end of the top of the eighth inning. A two-run shot for Xavier puts them up two runs, 6-4. We'll be back the bottom half of the eighth inning here in just a moment. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcats Sports Radio. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium, and Xavier takes a two-run lead, 6-4, after a two-run shot was hit late in the top of the eighth inning. Now Cincinnati brings out a pinch hitter in Cameron Guidry. Been known to be hot when he needs to be. Personally, one of my favorite players on this team. Has had many a walk-off.
Had those three home run games. Had that three in a row games hitting a home run.
That pitch inside for ball one was also brought home yesterday to bring in the run rule win for Cincinnati against EKU.
Yeah, he's been a really solid player for Cincinnati.
That one slapped deep into the gap between first and second act at the wall. That'll be a double for Cameron Guidry. Relay not in time.
Continues to be a really solid bench player for Cincinnati.
Cameron Guidry powerful with the swing. Shows the crowd why
Jordan Mitchell putting on a pinch runner.
He should be in there, and yeah, just like that, it'll be Dalton Pearson heading out to second base to pinch run for Cameron Guidry. Another speedy offensive player for Cincinnati. Leads the team in stolen bases with 13. Now Carrington Cross steps up to the plate. He's 2-for-4 today. Pitch on the way. Right down Broadway, 4, strike 1. Two doubles on the day for Carrington Cross. Zvera looks a second, now back to home. Pitch on the way, fouled off into the safety net. Alex Vera's line currently one inning pitch with one hit, one walk, one strikeout, and a double allowed. Most recently from Cameron Guidry. 0-2 the count on Cross. Swing and a foul ball. Really fighting in this at bat. Cross steps back into the box. Vera looks back to second, winds the pitch. Swing and a miss, Carrington Cross gets sent back into the dugout after the foul tips into the glove of Dupre. Brings up Josh Hegeman. Now following Carrington Cross. Hegeman 1-for-2 on the day. Single and an RBI. Receives the pitch from Vera. Down the middle, strike 1. Hegeman hits a .379 with runners in scoring position, a .444 with runners on. The .504 on base percentage. Pitch on the way, swung on and hit. Like Tapper over to the second baseman, over to first base in time, but not before advancing the runner as Pearson makes his way from second to third base. Now Josh Cross is going to make his way up to the plate. 13 home runs on the year. 22 extra base hits in total. Now looks like a little meeting of the minds for Xavier. So the infield's going to make their way in to talk to Vera. Carrington Cross, 1-for-3 on the day with a single. Flew out, walked, grounded out in the sixth.
Xavier's making a pitching change.
Looks like they will. I didn't see their head coach make their way out.
I don't think that's their head coach. I think that's their pitching coach. But
either way.
Change nonetheless.
New pitcher for Xavier. Don's number six. Goes by the name of Grant Stevenson. Excuse me, number 40. I'm not sure where he got six from. I saw a six somewhere. Or I'm just going crazy. One of the two. No, that is number 40. And that is Jake Lambden.
They just did a whole switch, actually. They had a pitcher come out, and he's playing in Jake Lambden's spot. And Jake Lambden is pitching.
Jake Lambden.
Which is why that wasn't their head coach.
Who has seen 14.2 innings of work, 6 hits, 5 runs, all of which are earned, 12 walks, 18 strikeouts on the year.
Grant Stevenson is playing shortstop now.
Grant Stevenson?
Number 6.
Interesting.
What an interesting change.
That completely confused me because I saw 6 come in and I thought to myself, oh, you know, there's your new pitcher, it's number 6, and I figured, you know, somebody, a coach would come out from the dugout to make the switch happen, but didn't. That's because your bullpen is now your shortstop. Jake Lambden, freshman infielder and pitcher, is a right-hander. Season high of 3 strikeouts against Creighton on the 14th of April. The changes made for Cincinnati. Not much of a warm-up being needed as he's already been out there through the past 8 innings. And now Josh Cross steps up with a clean count, 2 outs. One runner on, it's Pearson at third base. Lambden, the pitch. Outside ball 1. Right-hander favoring the third base side to the rubber. Half of his foot standing off of it. One of the count now. For Josh Cross as he takes time. Steps back out of the box and we'll step back in. Lambden's pitch. Swung on and hit high up in the air. Routine pop fly coming in as McCormick to grab it. Makes the grab, backtracking up to get it. That ends the bottom half of the 8th inning. On to the top of the 9th here in Cincinnati. Xavier leading 6-4 over the Bearcats. When we come back, you're listening to Bearcat Baseball here on Bearcat Sports Radio. Musketeers make a pitching change, and so do the Bearcats as Christian Mitchell steps onto the mound for the Bearcats, a two-way hitter, sophomore Central Michigan transfer. It's a third baseman for CMU, is an All-MAC second team, ranked second on the team with a .307 batting average and 8.841 OPS. And staying in the game, Dalton Pearson, who plays center field, and moving over to right field is Josh Hegeman as well.
Yeah, I was kind of expecting to see Christian Mitchell in this game, especially when he wasn't in the lineup at shortstop. Just seemed like he was going to be pitching to finish this game out. So.
Aiden Anderson steps up to the plate now, 0 for 4 on the day. First batter to face off against Christian Mitchell as his pitch is right down the middle for strike one. Mitchell on the season 0-1, 4 saves, 25.1 innings of work. That pitch shows blunt. Third baseman Carrington Cross comes in to get it. No play is there. Anderson's going to be safe at first base after the bunt. Christian Mitchell, 22 hits, 11 runs, 9 of which are earned, 7 walks, 7 Ks on the year.
Christian Mitchell's done a pretty good job of recently, pitching and hitting-wise. Fielding at shortstop is where he still has a lot of struggles, a lot of errors there, but a lot better from the pitching side than he was at the beginning of the season.
Hayden Christensen now is... There's a double play opportunity. Toss the second in time. Toss the first is in time. Catches Anderson going to second. Christensen is out at first base. Just like that, two outs. Ground ball, double play for Cincinnati. Now Cushing up the bat for Xavier. Cushing 1 for 4, pitch on the way. High, ball one. Cushing a double in the second, flew out in the third and struck out twice in the fifth and seventh. Winds the pitch, swung on, line drive, gets past Tommy O'Connor, out into the outfield. Able to track it down as Hegeman, who's now in right field. Stops the play. It's a good dive from Tommy O'Connor, just squeaked right past his glove. No play made. That bring us to McCormick. 1 for 3 as a home run on the day. Pitch on the way, swing and a foul ball. Christian Mitchell looking for a 1-2-3 inning. After the ground double play. McCormick looking to extend this lead for Xavier. 0-1 the count with two outs, one runner on. Down and away for ball one. Josh Cross able to track it down and hold the runner at first. Cushing stands at first with 7 stolen bases. He's been caught once this season. Count even at 1-2 outs. The pitch. Low for ball two. McCormick hits with a .324 average with 2 runners out. .323 with runners on. Mitchell winds and deals. Swung on and pops high up in the air. Has a beat on it. The shortstop, he steps down over and makes the catch. It's Carrington Cross, the third baseman. He retires the side. No runs have been scored, and down to the bottom of the ninth. It's time to rally for the Cincinnati Bearcats. We'll be back in just a few moments. You're listening to Cincinnati Baseball here on Bearcast Sports Radio. Welcome back to UC Baseball Stadium. Hunter, Jesse, Tommy O'Connor, and Loudon Brooks due up for the Bearcats to face off against Lambden, bottom of the ninth inning. Xavier leads 6-4 here in the Queen City. Kira Campbell, Ethan Herzog with you here on Bearcats Sports Radio. Bearcats look to mount a great comeback. I swear, I feel like every time I call my first game of the season, it's this situation with a walk-off. I am 1-for-2. The pitch from Lambden is outside for ball one. I only have one walk-off, and it's against Ohio State. It's my first baseball game ever.
I was at that game.
You were?
I was.
I didn't know you yet.
No.
Swing and a miss, strike one. Call for Hunter Jesse. He has home run with two RBIs attached to that one.
Walk off against my old school.
You admitted you went to Ohio State on air. That's crazy.
Yeah. Well.
For 1-1 pitch.
Called dozens of listeners.
Swing and a miss. 1-2 now the count for Hunter Jesse. O'Connor, Brooks, Palmieri due up for Cincinnati. Should the inning last that long, swing and a pop up out and foul. Everybody come your way. Hunter Jesse ready in the box. Lambden on the mound. Winds and deals. Outside. Ball two. The last walk-off home run was Cameron Goodger on April 11th of 2023. The last walk-off base hit was Cole Harding of April 2nd of 2023.
Cincinnati had a walk-off hit by pitch earlier this year.
Yeah, walk-off RBI without a hit. Josh Hageman, bases loaded, hit by pitch. As Hunter Jesse smacks that base hit. Left field. He'll have extra bases as he runs into second base standing. No outs for Hunter Jesse as he runs into second base. And that brings up Tommy O'Connor. The first baseman with a knack for hitting home runs. 10 home runs on the year, 44 hits, 5 doubles, 2 triples. As O'Connor is 0-for-4 today, is due. Pitch in the zone, strike one. Hunter Jesse stands on second, 3 stolen bases on the year for him. Lambden looks to second. Now back home. The pitch. Inside, ball one. 1-1 is the count. This is your tying run at the plate. In Tommy O'Connor. Lambden back to second. Now over to home. The pitch. Wild. The prey is able to track it down before any damage can be done, but now it's a 2-1 count. Jake Lambden has one save on the year in his 15 innings pitched and is 1-0. Pitch on the way. High, ball three. 3-1 is the count. No outs, one runner on. It's Hunter Jesse at second base. Tommy O'Connor stands in the box to bat for Cincinnati. Lambden looks back to second, now home. The pitch in the zone, strike two, full count. 3-2. Not a fan has left their seat.
More still coming in.
Gets to the last couple minutes
Swing and a miss. Tommy O'Connor gets out on strikes.
O'Connor saw the pitch that he liked. Just too far outside. Now Loudon Brooks. Up to bat for Cincinnati. 0 for 3 has a walk in the seventh. Ground out, a fly out, and a strikeout in the second, third, and fifth. Lambden looks back to second. The pitch on the way. Swing and a miss from Loudon Brooks. Still your tying run at the plate. Bearcats with 9 hits. Musketeers with 7. Both teams have an error apiece. Winds and deals. Wild pitch gets by the catcher. That'll advance Hunter Jesse to third base, now 90 feet away. Loudon Brooks now with a 1-1 count with one out, one runner on. He's on third. Loudon Brooks has 18 RBIs on the season. Pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. 1-2 the count. One, two count, one out. Lammed in the pitch. Check swing, did he go? Yes. Little strike out Loudon Brooks. That brings up Max Palmieri. Max Palmieri, who's 1 for 3 on the day. It's the Bearcats' last hope. Bottom of the ninth. Tying run. Max Palmieri pitch on the way. Down. Ball one. Hunter Jesse stands at third base after double and a wild pitch. Lambden deals. Outside ball two. Mentioned before, Lambden does have one save on the year. Stands on a 2-0 count against Max Palmieri. Pitch on the way. High ball three. Tension's so thick you could cut it with a knife. Count to Max Palmieri. Pitch on the way. Down and away for ball four. Runners on the corners for Cincinnati. Your game-winning run steps up to the plate. But not before mound meeting for the Musketeers. The infield is in. Talking things over one more time with runners on the corners. Two outs. Palmieri at first. Hunter Jesse at third. Sefcik is up to bat. Home plate umpire Grady Smith coming to break it up. Sefcik, who is 1 for 2 on the day. The DH makes his way to the plate. Two outs, runners on the corners for Cincinnati. Luke Sesek, the pitch on the way, swing and a miss, strike one.
All these Bearcat hitters are coming out swinging for the fences. I mean, you have to. It's the top, bottom of the ninth, but.
Just got to find the right pitch. That one, 78 mile an hour. Bottom corner of the zone. Time was called.
Another ball entered the field of play. Gets tossed back out. Lambden winds and deals. Swing and a miss. Strike two. Down to the final strike for Cincinnati. Runners on the corners. Palmieri at first. Jesse at third. Lambden waits. Looks. Deals. Swing and a drive. Bobbled by the shortstop, but it's going to be in time to second base. And that will do it from Cincinnati. Musketeers claim the season series 2-1 and claim tonight's match 6-4 at the bottom of the ninth inning. Cincinnati with 9 hits and 1 error. Musketeers with 7 hits and 1 error as well. Be a 3-hour game on the nose between these two crosstown rivals. Next game up for Cincinnati is take on Houston in a 3-game series coming up this weekend starting on Friday at 5 p.m. Bearcat Sports Radio will be here to cover and provide all of the action. One final time from UC Baseball Stadium for Kira Campbell, I'm Ethan Herzl. Saying so long from Cincinnati. The Bearcats fall to the Xavier Musketeers 6-4. Good night, everybody.